Hi, this is Axeman. Welcome to this lesson. This one is on chords. Now, it's got a lot of information. Going to go by real fast. Pause every time I do show you something new and make a chart of it, okay? First off, you're going to need a bunch of blank chord symbol things. Get that, and then we can go. Let me introduce you to the C major scale. That's written right here, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. And we're going to talk about the distance between notes. From C to D is 2 frets, D to E is 2 frets, E to F is 1 fret, F to G is 2, G to A is 2, A to B is 2, B to C is 1. Corresponds to the white keys on the piano, and the black keys are the ones, are the notes between the ones with 2 frets. Okay, now, from the first note to the second note is called a major second. From the first to the third is called a major third. From the first to the fourth is called a perfect fourth. First to fifth is perfect fifth. First to sixth is major sixth. First to seventh is major seventh. First to eighth is called an octave. Now, distance from the first to third, a major third, is 4 frets. Now, if it were 3 frets, it would be called a minor third. There are only 2 kinds of thirds, major third and minor third. Now, that's what we're going to be dealing with here. If you put a third, which is every other note, over each note of the scale, if you, the first note, it's a major third, the second note's minor, third is minor, fourth is major, fifth is major, sixth is minor, seventh is minor, back to the first major. Major and major on 1, 4, and 5, minor on 2, 3, and 6, and 7. Okay, now, if we were to put a third on top of each of those, we would get chords. If you, on the 1, it's a major chord, on the 4, it's a major chord, on the 5, it's a major chord, on the 2, 3, and 6, it's a minor chord, and on the 7, it's a diminished chord. Now, here's what the major one looks like. Here's what the minor looks like. Okay, and the diminished, there. If we add a third on top of each of those, then we get seventh chords. The 1 and 4 are major seventh, the 2, 3, and 6 are minor seventh, the 5 is just called a seventh, in this case a G seventh chord, and the 7 is called a minor seventh flat 5. Get more into this in later lessons, but I'm just going to rush by that for you. Okay, now, when we have a chord, here's C, E, G. It's a C chord. The C is the lowest note, so it's called a root position chord. Here's the same notes, E, G, C, but the C is not the lowest note, the E is. That's called a first inversion chord. Okay, and then here we have the fifth of the chord is the bottom note, so it's called a second inversion chord. Okay? Now, here are the chord shapes that I build everything from. This is the A shape, the open A shape. In fact, here's the open A chord. You see that? But the shape is, that's there. There's the root, the third, the fifth, root. Root, third, fifth, root. A shape, okay? And here's the other scale numbers that are around it in the major scale. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Okay? Now, that's what the A looks like. If you move it up the neck, there, it's up one fret, it's B flat, but it's the same shape. Okay? Now, the minor from the open A shape, there's the major, there's the minor. Just lowered the third, so it's 1 flat, 3, 5, okay? We move it up the neck, move it up one fret, it's B flat minor, move it up B, C, and so on and so forth, okay? Draw these, pause it and draw them, okay? Now here's a diminished from the same family, okay? To get it diminished, you lower the third and the fifth. Well, here I'll start. Here is a C major. Now made it C minor. Now to make it diminished, that shape, okay? Now, these are the sevenths and sixth chords built from that family. So here's your There's C, C major 7th, C 7th, C 6th. Here's another way to do C 7th. They're all there. I have little time, so here I'll just speed by. And here's the minor versions of the same. I'm not going to play them, but you can try them yourself. Just draw them and then play them. Okay? Minor, major 7th, minor 7th, minor 6th, another version of minor 7th, okay? Now here's the next chord family. This is based on the open F chord. And the root is on the second string. But you notice that it has the third as the lowest note, so it's a first inversion. And these are the scale numbers that go around, the, you know, the do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, okay? So, this is the open F chord. You're familiar with that, I'm sure. Move it up there on the third fret. It's A flat. Okay. Now, the minor version of that. We have, for the F, the third is there, and third's on two different strings, so we have to lower both of them to make it a... So here I'll do it with G. Here's G. Here's the third, the 5-1-3, so I got to lower both of those to make a G minor. And that's a movable minor chord, okay? With the root on the second string. Here it is moved. This is the diminished version of the same one, which looks like that. That's a G diminished right there. Flat 3, flat 5, 1, flat 3. And here are all the sevenths and sixths from that shape, from the F, open F family. This little shaded box, that's where the one would be, so you got your orientation. So here, if I had a G major chord with the third in the bass and I want to make a major seventh, I just lift that finger. There's my G major seventh right there. And so on and so forth. And here are the minor shapes from the same family, and there's the root. Okay. Here's the next shape, the D shape. Your open D chord. I do it with one finger. You can finger it any way you want. There you go. But to move it up, you're going to have to bar it. And there's the root. And it's got the fifth as the lowest note, so it's a second inversion chord. There's your open D, root. Here it is moved up. E flat, E, F, and so on. And here's the minor from the same family. D major, D minor. We lowered the third. Still a second inversion chord. And here that is moved up here at the second fret. It's an E minor. And if we lower the fifth, we got a diminished. Okay, and then here's all the chords in that family. The sevenths and the sixths. Major seventh, there's the root. Different versions of the sixth. There you go. And here's the minor versions from the same family. Have to rush through. YouTube only gives you 15 minutes, so here we go. And here's some more. Now, the D family, open D, is real related to the open C, because they both share the 5-1-3 as their bottom notes. Here's, you know, 5-1-3-5. With the open C, it's 5-1-3-1. So they share some things in their shapes. It's just these are higher up, the D shape, they're lower. So there you go, those. And, like I say, there's the open C chord. And the scale numbers that go around it. We'll be doing a lesson on scales at a later time. Here's the C. There it is moved up, D flat. And here's a minor built from the open C. You can't do it on C, but if you move up, like here is D minor from the open C. You got a big stretch here though. and there's a diminished built from that. And our final shape is the open G shape. I like to play it this way, but you can finger it any way you want. In fact, my philosophy is find every possible way to finger a chord, because you never know which fingering you'll need when you're playing melody along with it. Anyway, this one has the root in on the low string, so it's a root position chord. Now, you notice if you put your finger there, then it's a first inversion chord built on the F shape. So the open F shape and the open G shape share this part of the shape. Okay, root there and there. There's your open G. Move it up the neck. A flat. Takes a while to get used to this fingering, but becomes easy after practice. Now the minor version is the same. There's your open G minor, so you move it up. And there it is, moved up. And here's a diminished built from that one. So if you were to actually play the open G, to diminish it, you would lower the 5 and the 3. And that's what we've done here. So moving it up the neck is a diminished chord. And here's shapes built from the open G. And this shaded part is where the 1 would be. Okay, so you can see that. Here's G major 7. So here I'll go through the G, G major 7, G 7, G 6. It's just lowering. And there's the minor ones. Here's G minor major 7, G minor 7th, G minor 6th. Got it? And that's our lesson for today. I hope you get a lot out of it. I know I crammed a lot in a short amount of time. Practice those chords, work the fingers on them, and pretty soon it'll be easy. Take care. See you next time.